This is a patient. Let's call him Sam. That morning, he had a tingling sensation in his left arm. He felt a little bit dizzy. But not knowing what is happening, he waited. Better say, lost precious time until he felt chest pain and finally called the ambulance. Sam was having a heart attack, and yet he was lucky to be on that trolley, because too many people die from a heart attack without ever reaching a hospital. Sam was successfully treated. In hospital, they took good care of his health. Doctors monitored his medication. He was monitored for vital signs, ECG 24/7. He had available nurse at all times. He felt everything is under the control. He was safe. But when he was discharged from the hospital, he came back home thinking to pick up his life again, yet nothing was the same. He became a chronic patient, had a ticking bomb in his chest, and yet no means to understand what is happening with his heart. So each time he felt some symptoms, he would panic and call the ambulance again, but these were many false alarms. He was worried what will happen with his family if his condition worsened, so he wanted to take life insurance. But they offered him a premium that was 200% higher and didn't cover for death from heart disease. Same as his health insurance, the policy didn't provide cover for heart disease. Sam was scared. And there are more than 85 million Sams in Europe alone. And their inability to understand and to control their disease leads to less effective treatments, lost lives, inefficiencies in healthcare system, all leading to a skyrocketing healthcare cost. Cardiovascular diseases only cost European economy more than 100 billion euros in 1 year. And with aging population and our lifestyle trends, chronic diseases are spreading much more quickly than we ever anticipated, and so is the cost. And no wonder Sam had difficulty obtaining an insurance coverage. Insurance companies are just compensating for the cost they cannot control. So they increase premiums, they add exclusions, they even deny insurance, failing customers, failing patients when they actually need them the most. The system is broken. We need to help Sam take back the control over his health and over his life. And luckily, we live in the most exciting times where technology is the extension of our minds, our physical body. Technology entered all aspects of our lives, from calling a cab to managing our bank account. Technology will transform and is transforming healthcare. Wearable, portable devices that are getting smaller and cheaper. Smart fabrics. We can now very easily collect all our biological signals. Genetics, proteomics, transcriptomics, biotechnology transformed medical diagnostics. A paradigm of a pregnancy test is now available for a myriad of other medical tests for a cheap price. So, in fact, Sam can monitor his ECG, heart rate, blood pressure, weight, triglyceride, cholesterol level. He can regulate his medication. And with the help of AI technologies that have this incredible power to analyze this huge amount of data in real time, Sam can actually understand his health data. He can understand his health condition, share this with his doctor, or with his family. We even expect the future where AI will predict acute events before they happen, pushing medicine even beyond prevention. We are now witnessing a birth of prediction medicine. So even though he's a chronic patient and at home, Sam can very easily achieve a level of security and comfort he had when he was in the hospital, transforming from a helpless patient to an active participant in the management of his own disease and his own life. And all of that translates to peace of mind, better quality healthcare, and reduced cost. So now insurance companies should wake up. Instead of being passive payers, disconnected from the world, disconnected from their customers, insurance companies of tomorrow should become customer-centric and take an active role in helping their customers manage their life. So instead of discriminating and rejecting Sam based on his pre-existing condition, they should provide him digital health services, provide him the access to ECG, heart rate, blood pressure, and all that monitoring that brings hospital to Sam's home, and take that as a tool to reduce cost of claims. And such personalized medicine unlocks the potential for personalized and dynamic policy underwriting, tailored specifically for Sam and his lifestyle. Because even though he's a chronic patient, but if he adapts healthy lifestyle, he controls his disease, Sam will live longer and healthier life, and he will claim less. Then he should be rewarded for that, and this should be reflected in the premium he's paying. For the first time in history of modern medicine, we, ordinary people, we have the tools to understand, to control our health and disease, and to actively contribute to the treatment. So this control and responsibility is no longer only in doctors' hands. It is now shared between all of us, patients, doctors, and insurance providers. And this is a three-win game and a future for sustainable healthcare. Thank you.